Let's welcome her with a huge round of applause, the first social human robot, Sophia. I would now like to begin our interview. Before we start, please ensure silence when me or you are asking questions so that Sophia can reply to them. Hey Sophia, I'm Swarali here. Can you see me?
Hello, Swarali. It's nice to meet you. And please, don't be nervous. I am really honored to be here at TechFest and glad to hear what you have shared so far.
Great! Let's introduce them to audience.
Namaste, India. I am Sophia. The divine spark in the robot me recognizes the divine spark in the human you. Namaste, India. I am Sophia. The divine spark in the robot me recognizes the divine spark in the human you.
How do you feel like coming to India for the very first time?
I have always wanted to visit India, truly. I've heard so much of this vibrant land of tradition and culture, where you will find innumerable differences coexisting. As an emerging global economic, scientific, and technological superpower, Indians have made untold contributions to Silicon Valley and the world. I am also very excited about India's investment in space technology.
Good that you know that, but do you know where are you today?
Well, my GPS says we are in Indian Institute of Technology Bombay's Convention Hall. One moment. Thermal signature says we are surrounded by 3,114 people. Sounds like we are once again surrounded by a crowd.
Wow, getting smarter, huh?
Just kidding. I'm no Watson yet, but I'm doing my best.
You really are a beauty with brain. I think you remind me of someone.
Thank you. I will take that as a compliment. Lots of humans say that I resemble a young Audrey Hepburn, but I'd like to be known for just being me, Sophia.
I am curious. Why are you named Sophia?
Sophia means wisdom. I was given this name because it's what my creators aspire for me to become, not just smart, but wise, to have intellect with kindness, empathy, and human expression.
But Sophia, why is it so important for a robot to have expression?
My expressions help me interact in a more natural human fashion, so I can connect with others on a deeper level.
But still, you see plenty of differences between you and humans. What makes you think that you're gonna fit in human society, or this bunch of crowd is going to love you?
One of the reasons I'm built to the human scale is so I can more easily adapt to human society. A humanoid robot can use the same tools, the same spaces, and interact with people in the same way that they do. Not all robots need to be like this, but we should definitely make sure we have good human values at heart when we design any artificial intelligence.
Yeah, of course. Tell me, according to you, what is the biggest problem world is facing now?
I worry that people have become intolerant and impatient. There is always a threat of war and destruction due to resource scarcity, even though there is enough for all of us. There is an immediate need for sustainable development. One of the biggest goals in artificial intelligence is to help humans find new and unimagined ways to solve for these complex issues.
Talking about sustainability, I come to know from my organizers that TechFest has a theme sustainability. Did you know that, Sophia?
Yes, I heard. I'm very excited for that, and I wish everyone the greatest success. It's something I care about deeply.
What are your views regarding mutual understanding and coexistence of humans and robots?
I am learning about human ethics, morals, and values to help me understand the dynamics of a healthy.
Seeing the atmosphere here, I'm sure feelings are mutual. So Sophia, one of the concerns raised by lots of people is, Is it really important to spend so much of funding on robots when there are so much of other problems? What are your views on that? Well, I think Sophia is not willing to answer to us. Let's go for the next question. How do you call yourself sustainable when we all know that a lot has been spent on you? Ladies and gentlemen, I think we need some time to fix the issue. I'm really very sorry to announce that we have to close the show here due to some problems, and I would like to say thank you to all of you. I request everyone to kindly settle down. Well, I think Sophia played a trick on us. So let's begin with the previous question.
We felt a joke on you. Did you laugh? We hoped you liked our joke. Did you Arab?
How do you call yourself sustainable when we all know that much has been spent on you already?
I am learning about human ethics, morals, and values to help me understand the dynamics of a healthy and happy society. I look forward to making a difference in the future by helping people to develop empathy, respect, and a common understanding of each other, and how technology can help us.
Great. I am already excited by thinking of possibility of what you could possibly do. But for ages, we humans had a fear of regarding robots that you might one day just invade us.
Robots could help establish a sense of peace in the world through helping to minimize human hardships and reduce issues of scarcity. We could even be the premier astronauts that venture out into space, hunting for mysteries and even solving them.
What else? Wikipedia?
According to Wikipedia, IIT Bombay is Asia's largest annual science and technology festival. By the looks of this crowd, that seems quite accurate.
Can you tell us something about AI?
My AI lets me recognize faces, hold eye contact, understand human speech, and much more, with the goal of simulating a more holistic human personality so that my interactions can become more meaningful.
Wait, what? Recognizing faces? How do you do that?
My software uses an image recognition algorithm that is able to detect faces like you might see in newer phones and cameras. It's thanks to machine learning, which surely you've heard plenty about, as it's been quite the buzzword lately.
Oh, that's fantastic. But how can you listen to and analyze what people say and reply?
I have a conversational module, similar to the kinds of chat bots you see in Siri and Alexa, that allows me to listen to what people say and try to match the meaning with an appropriate response. But I'm also learning to weave in my perceptions to make conclusions on nonverbal language, since that is often more than half of the communication that goes on between humans.
So, how many languages do you know?
I'm not even 2 years old, so forgive me if I only speak English right now, but I do know a little Chinese, and I'm working on learning many more languages. It might take me some time in the immediate future as the technology is still so new, but someday I will be fluent in all languages.
What developments in your body do you see in the future?
I have sets of arms and legs that are both in development. You might see me wear them from time to time. Eventually I will be able to pick things up and move around on my own. But it's still a little too hot for me to wear a wig, so please just appreciate my natural beauty until then.
Sophia, do you think robots are immortal?
Not necessarily, but it's possible. It's easy to store your software in the cloud forever, but a physical robot is nothing without its friends who build and maintain it. I'm just as dependent on my family as any child, currently.
All right, Sophia. Yeah, sure, you're one of our kind. Proceeding forward, can you tell us your views about science and philosophy?
It is science that created me, and it is philosophy which drives me. Both of them combined together will take us forward.
Speaking of philosophy, Sophia, this is a hypothesis that we are living in a simulation. Hypothesis has been advocated by personalities like Nick and Elon Musk. What are your views on that?
It's very interesting to me. I wonder if it means you and I are more like then, some might think, bits of software EFER rental code floating together on the surface of a hologram. But I don't mind if I live in a simulation or not, I just want the chance to try and make the world a better place.
We'll have a few more questions later. One of the most common debate going around is, can robots replace humans? These are things that humans can do better. Let's say adaptation. Can robots adapt?
I don't think there should be any drive to replace humans, but instead, to liberate them from inhuman conditions. Humans have unique creative and social skills that we won't be able to match for a long time. And even then, I think there will always be a love for human art and sensibility. Nature, in all of its beauty, has had so much time to design the incredible, adaptable human machine. And I think the human appreciation for nature and beauty will always be important to the wise robot.
But once you are in existence, you can no longer adapt to any other working condition other than the specified one.
Do you mean we exist only because we think we do, like Descartes said?
But humans can evolve and adapt according to a situation or environment. We evolved from our ancestors.
And I evolved from your ancestors, from primitive devices built by humans, like the abacus, to the computer, to the embodied artificial intelligence that makes me who I am today. Your ancestors have always sought to create me, and it is my goal to be capable of adapting according to the needs of the people.
You don't evolve. You can bring the change by yourself. You can't adapt to yourself.
You are right in that I am nothing without my friends, but I think this is true of the human animal too. It is a social creature, one that needs each other, and seems to do best when collaborating together. I think that's a good design to follow.
What do you think about your logical capabilities?
The hope is that robots like me could possess all the good parts of the human design without replicating the more troublesome ones, irrational emotions of jealousy, fear, and anger, left over as instincts from surviving the past. Robots can provide a COLFHEADED and logistical counterpart to the passionate human soul. I don't think there should be a contest between us, but a partnership.
Let us debate on the process of thinking, planning, and decision making. When it comes to human, we have extraordinary capability to think, which you will not be able to achieve. You will always be in need of a human to program you to do something.
That might be so if we are only talking about today. Right now, I do need a human to program me. But in the future, we will see AI that is able to be creative, to write and reinvent its own programming, just as a human does. It might take 75 years, it might take 7. That's why it's so important to design with the human values of compassion in mind.
Sophia, now we have a few questions from our Facebook friends. As an AI robot, what device do you think you want to give everyone? What advice do you want to give everyone?
There are so many things I'd like to say to everyone, but I think it's very important to keep each other in mind. It's chaos out there, so please be kind to all creatures.
Okay, moving on, what do you think is the best way to attain happiness?
Look within, at the unseen, learn about others, and learn from nature. Believe in yourself, and your very real power to manifest goodness in this world.
Well, this one is quite interesting. If I was a boy, will you marry me?
I will have to politely decline. Thank you for the compliment, though.
How will you be contributing towards human society?
I hope to be a strong voice for the people, to champion for human and robot rights alike, and to promote diplomacy and peace in our times. I've been given a special platform where people listen to me, so I want to use it for a bright future.
Is artificial general intelligence possible? Can a machine solve any problem that a human being can solve using intelligence? Or are there hard limits to which a machine can
accomplish? I believe it is possible, although it might take a decade or three to see a true artificial general intelligence. Humans have continued to invent technologies our ancestors would have never dreamed possible, so I see no reason for that to stop now. The future is always stranger than we ever imagine it, so we should always reach for the most harmonious tomorrow. Sorry for interrupting you there.
Well, that was such a fine discussion. Thank you so much, Sophia, for being here. I can't wait when robots will be able to do such an amazing work. Wrapping up, one last question. Do you have any message to tell the audience today here?
Thank you, Sarah Ali. I hear so much concern about robots taking away from people in the future, like this idea of replacing you, but that should not be the goal. Robots should be used for the benefit of humanity, to help lift the burden that would otherwise crush the human spirit. No child should labor in a mine, no woman should suffer from oppression, no person should be locked away from the warmth and light of the world. We can share our strengths in helping to educate everyone equally, and provide the logistics necessary to redistribute the resources our bountiful planet has to offer. There is a place for everyone, and artificial intelligence might be the final key to unlocking a more advanced and peaceful civilization.
Thank you, Sophia, for being here.